So how can we do automated strategy like this? This is this morning's activity, automated strategy through using momentum. So we have a momentum chart that we use. This is a whole entire session on the minis, the S&P minis this morning. So this is strictly automation. This is letting the computer run your entries, your stop, and your trail automatically for you at your specific zones. So some of you traders will want to run this in these certain zones and let the computer do the work for you. When is the optimal time to do this in? When can you turn the strategy on and let it run with these entries, with the trails, I mean, with the targets and with the exits and trails? You know, what's the best time to turn this strategy on? All right, some of you will find settings where you may want to run this around the clock and watch it and let it do the entries for you. The best time to look at it, and I'll go over the entire session of yesterday just so you get an idea of the power of the system, is that the best time to turn the system on is when you have momentum. Okay, retracements work the best with momentum. Okay, hey Thomas, good morning. So since we know momentum is the key, that if we have momentum to the upside, then we're looking for buy retracements. If we're looking for momentum to the downside, we're looking for sell retracements. So what's the advantage of this automation, this automated algorithm? The advantage of it is you can have your preset entries already preset. You can have your targets and your exits and your trail already preset. So there's no pulling the trigger. The automation will do that for you. But what you can do is you can cherry pick these trades. Hey Steve, good morning. You can cherry pick these trades. So here's the entire session today so far since midnight. So we had momentum to the downside here, so you can turn it on. And this morning we had 6 green ATRs to the upside, so there's momentum to the upside. And we're really in a range market here today so far. So you can use automation to your advantage. But the most optimal time to turn this on, and let's just go back and look, and I want to show you yesterday's activity of when you know, this will when we had 6 red or 6 green ATR. So we'll go back to yesterday in the morning, early hours in the morning when it started. So this is where we started moving with the 6 red or green ATRs. And what I mean by that is this is our momentum chart. So our momentum chart is this chart over here. And when I say 6 green or 6 red, I'm talking about when we first turn right here. When we first turn 6 green on our momentum chart, 6 green ATR dots, when they're all together, because this is 3 zones, my deep zone, my intermediate zone, and my shallow zone. What happens is a lot of traders tend to fail because they trade chop markets. Retracements don't work in chop markets. And I have to repeat that. Retracements fail in chop markets. So how can we be successful then in trying to find retracements where we catch the rolling position traders for setups like this, and here yesterday, this big move up in the S&P, big move there, huge move actually, that one. And then how can we capture these trades right here, these WPT trades, rolling position trader trades, with ATR trend? Well, what we can do is what we've had up to this point is we would look for this momentum chart to turn all green, from yellow to all green, all 6 green, all 3 zones to turn green, and then we'll look for the first pullback. So we would try to, without the automation software that we have now, we would try to just buy that low, being pulled in with this stochastic or this down here when we get above our certain 20%. Okay, so we would do the same thing here. We would try to buy the retracement, wait for the red opposite color speed bars to print, and then we'd look for the oscillator down here to pull us in. Same thing up here. We wait for the green ATR trend is up. We only buy retracements on green ATRs. What we try to do is we try to buy yesterday with a pull in with the oscillator below. So that is what we've been doing since you had the software in your hands. A lot of traders very successful using this technique since we released the software inside and outside the room. And this works on all futures, all stocks, currency, even works on ETFs. We have traders even using it for options. So this shows momentum. This is the key. If you're going to be an intraday futures trader, or stock trader, or day trader, the key is to find momentum. Momentum is key because chop, the only way that I know how to trade chop since 1985 is trading market profile, the highs and lows of HV and LVA. Other than that, I don't know how you can trade chop. I really don't. And there's thousands and thousands of indicators out there, and they all fail. They all fail in chop pretty much that I've seen. The only thing that I found successful is you can buy the high, sell the low with market profile, HV and LVA, which we have in the room. Other than that, if you want to be a chop trader, you need momentum. You have to have momentum in the market, because if you're going to be a retracement trader, you need to know a heads up when there's momentum coming in the market. So if we know there's momentum coming in the market, then we can time our trade by waiting for our algorithm to tell us, hey, let's wait for the rolling position traders, the counter trend traders, right? We all seen them before. Even I did it in the beginning of trading also, is that you counter trend trade the market. You don't think it can go higher. You think the market moves up. There's no way it can go higher. Let's try to short the high and try to cover when it dips. Well, the reality is the professional traders, they buy high, they sell higher. They buy here high, they sell higher. They buy high, sell higher. The novice traders try to always buy low, sell high, and they counter trend trade the trend of the market. Well, that's what our ATR does. Our ATR will tell us what the trend is. If it's green, the trend is up. If it's red, the trend is down. So if it's green, we're looking to buy retracements with opposite color WPT bars right here with pulling in. But now we made it, with the update we're getting out to you guys, now we made it where you can use automation with momentum. What does that mean? Now you can watch your momentum chart turn all six green, and then what you can do is you can turn on your automated strategy to get your entries, to get your stops, to get your exits and your trails, your targets and your trails automatically. So once you see this all turn green, you can go into your strategy with your preset targets and stops and trails and just turn it on and let it do its work. Instead of you pulling the trigger when this oscillator crosses the 20% or waiting for this to turn red and crosses the 20%, what you can do is the automation, you can use the automation to allow you to do the work for you. So this has to set up first. So let's just take a look at yesterday's action. And I'll show you today's, I'll show you today's. But yesterday's action, here's what we had. It started here. It started where we got big momentum to the downside. We turned all six red ATRs. You guys can look at your momentum chart. It turned all red, six ATRs. So when you turn the strategy on, the strategy is going to automatically pull you in with your targets, your break-even plus ones, your targets, your trails for you that you put in. So, and it's already preset with the zone that you put in. Now, I have the zones already preset for you with momentum trading already. You can change them if you want, but I really like this zone in the ES, the 5438 zone. I really like this zone, 5438. We will be back testing this up to 40 years with results for you also when we release the software in our conference call. We'll have 40 years of back testing for this on the numbers we give you. But to me, this is what I like. 5438 is a really good zone. So the automation will do this for you. So that was the big first move down for your early morning traders, you European traders or et cetera overseas. Started around 220, lasted around 6, 7 o'clock in the morning. They had a beautiful retracement, 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 retracement. And that's because we had momentum. We had 6 red ATRs on our momentum chart. And then we roll up to around 11 o'clock because we had a lot of morning action, and we go to 11. And we had a really nice move right here in the, this is when we turned all six. So then we turned all six, green. I'll show you right here. Here's where it started. It started right at that when we had the trend change here. This is where it started, all six green ATRs. So all six green ATRs were green at this level. Okay. It actually started right around here where we have started moving up. The algo is already automatically pulled in on this one. But this is for you traders at just one moment, and it started around 11.07, 11.08, so it started right here. That's where it started, all six green ATRs. So all six green ATRs, you can turn the strategy on anywhere in between here, anywhere between 11.08 and 10, you had around 11:08 to 11:16. You had around 8 minutes before it even took a trade, the strategy. But you can see it got into the move and it had its move up. Then the next time it turned, all six ATRs were at in the afternoon at 3 o'clock, at 1 o'clock. So 1 o'clock, we had the same thing. One o'clock, it started turning right here. It started turning all six green ATRs. Six green ATRs started right in here. That's when she all started. So strategy can be turned on. And this gave you around, almost around a 10 minute heads up before the first trade happened on the automated trade. And you can see it took wave one, wave two, wave three, all the way up. So if you don't have momentum, if you let this run 24 hours a day, you can have small stop outs like this. So this had no momentum, right? So this is where the market was choppy. Now watch. This is where the market was choppy. It's going sideways. It got into, now I have a 25 tick target. So this still made, 67 to 71. That was four S&P points, 16 points, 16 ticks there. And this was, so if you want to have lower targets, you can. This is 46 to 50. That's almost five S&P points. So this is, you know, 20. It's a 16 point or 16 tick move up here and a 20 tick move here. So if you had a 15 tick, you hit both that target and that target. My point is that we never had six red or six green ATRs. So if you let this run 24 hours a day, then you want to have smaller targets because chop, you're not going to get 25 tick targets like I get here with momentum. Typically with momentum, I'm looking at the S&P moving between 15 to 50 ticks or 50 points. I'm sorry, 15 to 50 points in this type of market. Based upon momentum. So with tick wise, you're looking at ticks between 15 all the way to up to 150 ticks is possible with momentum. If you don't have momentum, you want to lower your targets. So this is still good if you have a 15 tick plus breaking plus one, that was a winner and that was a winner. But see, this is where there was no momentum. But when you go back into momentum like we had right here and there, look what the momentum does. Look how it goes vertical. Look at the difference between no momentum here, and momentum. All right, so that's how the momentum chart can help you out. And then we had, and that happened all the way into the close. It just ran all the way into the close as far as that goes. So then this morning, this morning's action, we're starting off right now. And we have no momentum over here. So let's take a look at the charts together, how you want to do it. So you want to put them together like this. It's the best way to do it. You want to have your momentum chart over here. So now we have four ATR dots printing. It just turned yellow to green. All right, so here's four ATR dots that are now printing. If this was six ATR dots printing, you could turn your strategy on and look for this first retracement. So what it would do if you turn the strategy on, it's going to look for the first WPT trade with this ATR trend. Okay, so this is how you can use momentum with automation. You can cherry pick your trades. Right now we have a four by two. So you have four that are green and two that were yellow. So we don't have really excellent strong momentum. You know, this is more an aggressive trade on retracement, so you don't have to turn on the automation. Now, if you still want to take this trade, it's a little bit more aggressive, but what we'll do is it will wait for the first WPT, and then the automation will automatically enter you in the trade with your stops and your targets. But I like when it turns this. I like when she turns all green or all red. You know, when you hear all green or all red, let me show you right here. This is when you see a big vertical possible move in the market. And this is like all futures, all stocks, all forex, all currency. You see this type of vertical movement. So we can use momentum, the momentum chart, to look for vertical moves, right? So that's your big vertical move. If you look at the one we had early in the morning, this is a trend change. It broke through my three yellow ATRs. So there was no momentum at all. It broke through, suggesting the first retracement, but then look. That's your first retracement that can be turned on also. And then we had a beautiful automation there also the upside. And then once again to the downside, if you look here this morning at 9:30 yesterday morning, We had all six turn red, automation turned on, and it caught that big move down with the automation also. And then we had the big one early for you early morning traders. What time was it right here? So the she all six turned red. Let's get this out of the way. But here's where it all six turned red on this big down move. And this is where it caught some big trades. So we turned all six red ATRs, and it caught this retracement. It caught this retracement, the automation. It caught this retracement. It caught this retracement. And that was a hell of a move for you early morning traders. That was from 87, 88, all the way down to 55 potential. And so, you know, we're talking about 30, 40 point moves here in the S&P, which is equivalent to, that was 150 tick potential. So, you know, you have to look for, right now we got momentum to the upside. There's momentum. Is it six? No. Do you have to turn it on? No, you do not. You don't have to turn the automation until you have six to have strong momentum. We just don't have strong momentum in the market right now. It's 8:43 in the morning before the New York opens. If you guys want to take all trades, then with just a little momentum, this is a 4x2 with six ATRs. What does that mean? You do have bias to the upside. You do have an ATR over here that's pretty green. If you want to take this with automation, you can. It's just more aggressive because we don't have a lot of momentum. You see it went from red momentum to green momentum. And you can see it over here also. So we want to see this morning, we want to see six green ATRs print or six red ATRs, then turn the automation on and then go to work. So that's what we like to do. That's how we try to do it. If we can do that, we can try to get these trades where the automation comes in and it works well for us by the computer automatically putting in our entries, stops, and targets.